All right, so in this video, the only thing we're really going to do is connect the Arduino and upload a blank script. This may seem like kind of a silly first step, but it's something that's fairly easy to forget to do. And also, there are some things that can go wrong in this that will make running your actual programs basically impossible. So I have my Arduino Uno, which I've opened from the set, and I've got my USB cable, which is connected to my computer, which you can't see, but assume that it is. Make sure yours is actually connected. And then I've also got my Arduino IDE running here. And it's important to have this installed first, because when you install the Integrated Development Engine, the IDE, it will also install the drivers to be able to recognize the Uno or whatever type of Arduino you're plugging into the computer. So if you plug in the Arduino before you install the drivers, it may use the wrong drivers and that may cause issues. So it's important to make sure you have the IDE kind of installed with the drivers before you plug in your Uno. So this is what it looks like. You notice here inside here the port is set to Uno, but on port there's nothing, so nothing is connected to this currently. And they call this sketch. This is sketch May 20. This is just because I created this sketch on May 20. Sketch is basically what the IDE in Arduino calls the code, right? So you may see these called different things in different programming languages, but in this environment we call our code the sketch, right? At least that piece of the code. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this in. And you just plug in the USB ports. And you see it's plugged in and the LEDs are on, which is a good sign because that means that it is receiving power from the computer. Also, things are stable here, so it's not trying to do anything. If your Arduino had a code on it and it was trying to run that, you might see some flashing as it tries to do communication and things like that. So now in my IDE, if I come up to tools on this port listing, now I have a listing for COM3. Let's select communication port 3. And it says there's Arduino Mega or Mega 265. It's actually the wrong one. This should be an Uno, but I'm going to click that. Then on tools here, I'm going to make sure it's still on Uno. And now I should be configured and I should be able to upload a sketch to the Uno. Now, in this case, I don't want to upload it to do anything. I just want to upload and make sure it's not doing anything. And also a nice thing to do before you start off, if you are using an Uno that's been used for other projects, they may still have the code for that old project on the Uno. So before you start clicking things up or trying to set things around, it's a good thing to upload a blank sketch to it first, so that way you know that you're not having anything conflicting with stuff that's already on the chip. If I were to wire this whole thing up and then plug it in, it may start running an old code before I have a chance to upload whatever code I have. So if I have it not plugged into anything currently, at least no peripherals attached to it, then I can upload this blank code and then I know when I go to wire things up, it's not going to be doing anything weird before I upload the code I actually want to run. So I'm going to upload this, and when you upload it, it's actually going to verify and then upload it. So a lot of people click on verify first and then upload, but I usually just click on upload because it will verify the sketch to make sure that there's no errors before it uploads. Click on that. See it's compiling, so it compiles the sketch into machine code. Once it's got the machine code, it uploads it to the Uno. And again, if there's any issues with the verification or compiling step, it'll let you know here in the debugger. It tells me how much was used. There's a little bit of flashing there as it communicates with the USB, and then it says done uploading. And so I was successfully able to upload this blank sketch to this Arduino Uno. Again, if you can't do that, you're not going to be able to do anything else inside this system. So it's good to make sure that you can get that process working so you know that that's not the error going forward.